Life. 40 years had passed since she had closed the large fence behind her for the last time. The fence she had carefully stained for several years. Now it was sagging and partially covered with moss. Several planks were rotten and most likely hadn't seen stain for a long time. She saw the neglected garden. The path was completely overgrown. She didn't dare look at the house, but it was inevitable. At first, she looked in the direction of the fruit trees and thought of the dozens of jars of fruit jam she had made every year. The beautiful cherry, apple, and plum trees were gone. She fought back the rising tears. "What did you expect?" she said to herself. After all, not everyone liked gardening. But the house. She finally looked at the house and realized she should not have come here. It hurt, but after all that had gone wrong in her life, she endured the pain. She had learned that acceptance was the best solution to survive. Luckily, she had fully enjoyed this once beautiful house and garden. She remembered the apple blossom branches in the beautiful blue-green vase. The vase was still in her apartment, but she had to buy the branches now. Looking at her skinny, wrinkled, and blue-veined hands, she thought of all the work she had done here. Always with so much attention, care, and love. For a moment, she felt as old as the house and the garden. Then she straightened her back. What once was will not come back. The sky remains, but the clouds come and go. They were fleeting, like life itself. When she touched the wood of the fence, two planks fell down, as brittle as puff pastry. A boy cycled past. "Hey, lady," he called. "Don't break things down." She smiled at him and softly said to herself, "Breaking down? I built it up." She walked away, a small piece of wood in her hand.